times are seeing unprecedented hair fall, and no one seems to have any clear idea about what to do about it. Now that's fair, because hair fall doesn't happen because of just one reason. It's a mix of your genetics, the lifestyle that you have, and your hair habits. But we are here to break down what is it that makes hair grow, how hair anatomy works, and hence what we can do actively to make sure that our hair grows out super strong. But before we get into how to make your hair grow more, it's important to understand how your hair grows in the first place. Hair is basically made up of two parts: the living, which is under the skin, contained in the follicle, and the non-living part, which is above the skin, which is also called the shaft. So it's basically the strand of hair that you see. Now the hair follicle is the one that gets all of the blood supply and is basically like a covering protective sheath around the hair strand that you have. So these new cells keep getting generated, stick together and harden. The full strand of hair develops from this group of hardened hair cells, and because the new hardened cells keep attaching to the hair from below, it's gradually pushed out of the skin. The blood in your scalp supplies the follicle with oxygen and nutrients to the hair root, which is what helps your hair grow. Okay, I know it's a lot of biology, but think of your hair and scalp basically like this plant. So you have the roots, which is underneath the soil, and you have the stem that grows out of it. So you've seen those fast videos of like plants growing. Your hair is basically more or less doing the same thing, where it's growing out of the soil, and the quality of the stem or the leaves is a function of how nutrient rich the soil is. So does your hair grow uniformly through your lifetime? Well, not really. It goes through three main stages. One is the growth stage, which is the anagen stage, in which it's basically on steroids. It's like a rocket ship. It's multiplying. The cells are multiplying. Your hair is growing. It's kind of getting all of the blood supply and nutrition. It's rocking. Then there is the regression stage, where it starts a little bit cutting off from all of the blood supply. So the strand basically isn't as healthy anymore because it doesn't have as much nutrition. And finally, it is the telogen stage, where it's just a resting stage, where it is cut off from all blood supply and it's just hanging out there waiting to fall out. And the falling out is the exogen stage. Why you have hair loss is because of two reasons. One is either that the anagen stage has gone directly to the telogen stage. So from growth stage, for whatever reason, it is basically the growth stage has been shortened and you've basically moved directly to the stage of resting. Now that can happen because of a host of reasons, and we'll come to that. But the other reason is also that your hair follicle itself is damaged. Now this is a super important line, so listen carefully. You are born with all the hair follicles you will ever have. Which basically means that you can't grow new follicles. So you cannot have more almost pockets of growth. You can just make sure that your pockets of growth continue to grow healthy hair throughout your lifetime. And you can do this by three main ways. One is, we know how important blood supply is for new hair growth. The second is to enhance cell regeneration ability. We said hair is basically a lot of cells regenerating and making sure that the strands are getting pushed out or the hair is getting pushed out. So anything that's going to enhance making cells faster is great for your hair. And the third most important part is to protect your follicle. Your follicles are basically home to all the hair that you'll ever have. So you have to make sure you protect it from what? From sun damage, from inflammation, anything that's going to basically prevent your follicles from being able to create new hair or regenerate new cells. Got it. So you basically got to make sure that you don't restrict blood supply, that you're doing everything you can to make sure the cells keep regenerating, and you don't let the hair follicle get affected because it's sensitive. So what are the three things that can improve blood circulation? So one is massaging your scalp. This is a research that we had cited in the previous, one of the previous videos, where basically there was this group of men in Japan who massaged their scalp every day for 4 minutes and they saw an increase in hair count. So massaging is definitely one. The second is topical application. So applying on your scalp ingredients or product that stimulate blood circulation. Rosemary oil is one such ingredient, and we'll talk about that a little bit later. And the third one is to prevent anything that basically constricts your blood vessels. So smoking, right? Anything that is stress inducing basically constricts your blood vessels, and that will lead to long-term impairment of your hair follicle. Now we come to the second part of wanting the cells to regenerate as fast as possible to make sure that when our hair is in the anagen, which is in the growth phase, it grows out super strong and super thick, right? So there are some things that we can definitely do, and a big part of that is the nutrition and the food that we take, right? So there are a couple of foods that contribute a lot to hair growth, and one big one of them is protein. So you have vitamins, especially vitamin C, vitamin B12 and vitamin D. Then you have some minerals, which is zinc and iron, which contribute a lot. And finally, you have omega-3 fatty acids. All of these put together contribute a great deal in your hair growth journey. Now remember that your hair is basically protein, which is why to help regenerate faster, it's great if you have a protein heavy diet. And the last and most important part of making sure you can grow out your hair is to make sure you don't damage your hair follicle. Now typically hair follicles can get damaged either because of some kind of treatment that you went through, but also and increasingly because of sun and UV ray damage. So this brings us to the Rosemary Festival, which is something we are celebrating at Sacred Grove all through the month of May. We're going to be talking about the benefits of rosemary, how it works, why it works, and what is it that you can do to keep it or make it a part of your hair schedule. Now, what we know for a fact that rosemary does is three things. One is that it improves blood circulation. The second is that it helps antioxidant ability, which means that there's less free radicals, which means that your scalp is able to reduce cells faster. And it is anti-inflammatory, which means that it prevents inflammation of your hair follicles, which in turn affects hair growth. So remember, your hair is basically exactly like this plant. And whatever you imagine works for this plant is definitely something that works for your hair, including keeping yourself super hydrated. Jen. Happy summer.